Hey, this is Mike Muir from Suicidal Tendencies, and you're listening to Dinitus.
We're here with none other than the legendary Mike Muir. Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
First, let me ask you this. World Gone Mad came out last year in September. And apparently you made some statements that it might be the last ever studio album of Suicidal Tendencies. I hope that was a mistake and you're planning to do 20 more.
Well, when we did our first one, it was a good chance it would be our last one. I think that a lot of times people try to get too far ahead of themselves. And I think that there should be an urgency and in the moment of what you're doing, a purpose and a cause. And I think after you do so many records, I think for a lot of bands, it's just a habit. It's been this amount of time, you do another record and it's all they know how to do. And for us, I felt that on a lot of levels, if we wanted to do a record, I want to do a record that I felt like, hey, this is a good ending point, we'll be happy with. Be a record that, you know, my definition of good and important is the most important thing. It goes back to whether if I could go in time when I was 16, if I heard this record, what would that person say? And that person was a very music critic, so to speak, didn't like a lot. And I think that person would really love this record. And so I think, you know, we have a lot of stuff going on with this, a very busy schedule. And then you have to deal with the fact that life's different than when you're 17 and 18 and starting, and you know, when you get 50 and you have kids and family and, you know, and back surgeries, things like that. So you know, we like to take the approach that, you know, every show, every tour we do, before we do it, we discuss it if it's something that we really want to do. And we do it and we want to be come across as the best possible we can, rather than, I think, maybe some other bands that are older and it's almost more nostalgic than inspiring. And I think that we try to, as much as possible, would prefer to be inspiring rather than nostalgic.
Is it correct that you already have enough material for an EP that might come out soon?
At the same time, we recorded an extra songs that we were going to put out the EP, and originally we were going to put it out on the inauguration day. And then due to the politics and everything like that, I realized that it would probably be perceived the way a lot of other people do things for the politics, and it would be away from the music and what the music had to actually say and stuff. I think it's I hate talking politics, I always have, and it's something that takes so out of context, but I enjoy talking to people from the left, I enjoy talking to people from the right, because I think most of them are full of crap.
Can you say feel like shit? Yeah, maybe sometimes I do feel like shit. I ain't happy about it, but I'd rather feel like shit than be full of shit. And if
I think most of them are like a board, they're stiff like this, and they refused to use any logic. A board doesn't use logic, it is what it is. And they fail to see anything that doesn't fit into their ideology, rather than, you know, right and wrong. My dad said right and wrong is not left or right, it's common sense. And so sometimes you're forced to, you know, try to correct people that say things that they know aren't true, but it's a great sound bite and it's a great rally cry and stuff. And I mean, it's sad when, I don't like Trump, obviously, but, you know, it's an easy thing to attack, and people say, he said this, and I'm like, actually, that's not what he said, you know, and, you know, that's maybe your interpretation or what you want to say, but it's not what he said, and it's sad when I have to defend someone like that. And in the same sense, well, Hillary, I'm like, well, fucking Hillary, let's talk about that bitch, you know what I mean? And I think that, you know, Hillary's the only person that Donald Trump could have won, you know? And you get into the whole party, the establishments and the Democrats, and they didn't want anybody else to run. They wanted there's so many things politically that people don't want to talk about, the levels. They just want to make it simple to their causes. And so I hate politics. I always hate politics because nobody really talks. The truth just gets so lost, you know? It gets so much theatrical and so much fucking hyperbole and this and that, and it's a joke, and it doesn't do anything good for the average person.
The reactions of the press and the fans have been very positive about the latest album. Would you feel in a way insulted if I said that perhaps the band got a breath of fresh air with Dave coming in and the other two new members?
Oh no, because there's very much a truth to that, you know. Obviously, there's a lot of different levels with Dave. One is, there's obviously he's you know, word legendary. He's a very legendary drummer. There's, you know, hundreds of thousands of people his favorite drummer, and I understand why. And I've always been on the outside, so to speak. You know, we toured with Slayer. I've always loved the way that he's played. And I mentioned it, a friend reminded me a while back that did an interview, and they said, you know, you always get these young people and they go, you know, and no one knows and this and that. If you were to get somebody that was in a band, who would you get? And the first person I said, well, probably Dave Lombardo and stuff. And they're saying, why? And I go, I just remember we played the Clash of the Titans and every night I watched them and that. And there's a lot of people that I've respected over the years, and as they've gotten older, they've adapted, and using that as a diplomatic word. But playing with Dave, it's like he's got the same philosophy we have. We're not trying to live off of our past. We want to go there every night and, you know, remind people why they love the band. We want to go out there and prove to people that we're different and that we're a great band, and we don't want to live off the past and stuff and just be like, have people be nostalgic. We want them, you know, to, like I said, to be inspiring. And that's Dave's approach every night. You know, he's out there and he's just pounding and really drives the band tremendously and stuff. So
can I pick up on the nostalgia bit, because you're already going into one of my next questions. I was wondering if you ever considered doing a tour around one of the classic albums, Join the Army, Lights, Camera, Revolution, How Will I Love Tomorrow, where you play all the songs, like, you know, it's when you're celebrating the 20th, 25th, 30th anniversary of an album. Do you consider something like that?
No, I never have. I think that would really come off as the old people, like, oh, we're gonna go get drunk and, you know, type of thing. I think that we've been fortunate that being able to play, and especially in Europe, a lot of festivals, and having a band that a lot of people may not have heard the music, but they've seen the hats, they've seen the clothes, they've seen the different people and, you know, skaters, surfers, action sports people that are into the band. So they know the name and they kind of say, well, see the picture, and they're like, I don't really look like that. But when we're at a festival, it's like, okay, I'll check it out. Mm-hmm. And so we've always been able to get new people that way. And I think some of the older bands, their following is very old. And I think it would probably be a lot of older people that would come. But I don't think it would be something that the 17-year-old kid me would want to go to see.
Perhaps. I have read some pretty amazing metal and punk rock biographies. Can we hope to read the ultimate Mike Muir biography one day?
No. No. Never something I'm completely not interested in. I've read a few things from a few people, and I think it's absolute rubbish. I think it's rubbish because I don't buy it. I don't believe it's honest. I believe it's a person that's sitting there trying to sell something. I remember when I was 16, I was going to college and I had a political science class, and the professor said, you know what? Too many people we have a tendency to believe. It's a weakness in the human, where certain people just are skeptical by nature, but we have a tendency to believe what we want to believe. We want to, whether it's for a God or this or that, we buy a book and we want to, like, it's like we're worshiping, it's like a Bible. And there's so many things that we want to make it be profound. We want to make it feel important. And he goes, you know, there's a library full of thousands of books. And before you spend time, you know, hours reading something, 300 pages, find about the author. Why is it so important for him to try to give his opinion to you and you have the same opinion? I don't believe in followers. I believe in, I would say, you know, it's I'd rather motivate than the followers. Like we always say, it's like, hey, I have a voice. I'm trying to tell people how to think. I'm trying to make sure that they are thinking. And whether their opinion is different than mine, but if it's based upon, you know, validity in their own certain way, that's fine. If they have opinions for what's right for them, not out of a selfish way, but of, you know, of knowledge and understanding, I enjoy that. I don't want to be in a world surrounded by the people who have the same opinion. Mm-hmm. When they want to take it militaristic and stuff and say, you have to believe in what I believe or I'll kill you, I have a problem with that. Mm-hmm. That's where I have a problem. Okay. You know, when people can't discuss things and stuff. But I have found that I've seen people talk about certain people. I won't mention names, but they do spoken word. And they go, oh, look at that, dude, you could do that and stuff like that. I go, of course I could do that. Mm-hmm. And I see a bunch of people sitting there and plotting and this and that. And I go, that's not fucking life. I would rip into those people. Mm-hmm. Why the fuck are you here applauding everything, trying to be entertained? Yeah. I'm not a fucking circus clown. Yeah. No. You know what I mean? There's something inherently wrong. Yeah. You know what I mean? And so I've spent lots of times after shows talking to people for half hour, this or that and stuff. And it just comes from a different place. You know, mm-hmm. I can make a lot of money, you know what I mean? And I think that's the purpose of most people where they're doing it. It's to make money.
That's true.
It's to make money. They're not giving the books away free.
No, that's true. You're the one that's crazy. You got me crazy.